One issue that I've argued all along that should have always been a local level, we should have never allowed it in, get into the courts, was the issue of abortion. We should have never permitted the Roe versus Wade situation to be ruled, because life and liberty and violence should be dealt with at the state level. If we're to defend the right of the individuals to lead their life as they choose, even when they make the wrong choices, we have to be certain that we defend all life. If we only defend life at certain stages, then I think it's very difficult to defend liberty. And this is what has happened. We have gotten careless. It was during my training in medical training, when I was studying to be OBGYN doctor, that abortion was being done, but it was done illegally. And I had an example of a time accidentally walking into an operating room where they were doing this. And they delivered a small baby, a couple pounds, and they pretended that it wasn't alive yet, was breathing and crying. They put the baby in a basket and turned their backs and didn't do anything. And it was at that time that I knew that something had to be done. Something was going wrong in this country with this total lack of respect for a live human being. And it is so important that we defend life in order to defend our liberties. Since 9/11, of course, we passed a lot of legislation. One of the most atrocious pieces of legislation, although championed, unfortunately, by the majority still in Congress, and that is the Patriot Act. I don't think we need the Patriot Act. That bill was brought to the floor shortly after 9/11, within a week or two. And by the way, it had been proposed even before 9/11, so there were always individuals wanting to pass that kind of legislation. The bill was presented to the House just hours before it was debated on. It was a very complex bill, and it passed easily. And when I asked the other members, why did you vote for the Patriot Act, I said, you didn't even have a chance to read it. And they said, yes, but we have this crisis, and the people want us to do something. It's called the Patriot Act, so I had to vote for it. That is an absolutely careless attitude in how we've gotten ourselves into such trouble. And now we have a country and an executive branch now that has so little respect for our privacy. We have warrantless searches, and they have challenged the whole concept of habeas corpus. Let me tell you, if I ever have the opportunity, I will never abuse habeas corpus for any American citizen. And there will be no warrantless searches. And so often they tell us this is so necessary for law enforcement. But they've been doing this for years for people they're looking for to make sure they pay all their taxes. And they have this, to me, a very, very unwise war on drugs. This war on drugs has not worked, and we need to address that someday. But the bottom line is, who has the responsibility for our lives? And I say we do. We have responsibility for our own lives. But it also means that if we don't do right, if we do things wrong, then we have to suffer the consequences, whether it's economic harm or physical harm to ourselves. But if we arm other people, then there's a role for government. We can't allow that to happen. We have to respect other people's lives, other people's property. We have to respect the contract. This is what makes the free market and the free system works, if you have respect for others. That is why when you promote freedom, we bring people together, because we're not going to deal with how to run their lives. Our responsibility will be for how we run our own lives. I think it would be appropriate, if it is to be that I'm to be the president, that I take a pay cut. Now, the reason is that I don't want to spend any time running your life. I don't want to spend any time running the economy, and I don't want to spend any time running the world. So there. But we do have a wonderful opportunity right now in this campaign and what's happening in this country. We have the young people energized. We have most of America realize there's a problem. Most everybody remembers and knows a little bit about history, about what America is all about, what sound money is about, what contracts are about. This is so different than when there was a collapse in the Soviet system. They didn't have these traditions. So there's every reason in the world to be optimistic about what we can do for ourselves. We just need to get the government out of our way and leave us alone. Now, if we expect that to happen, we have to reject in its entirety this whole notion of a national ID card. We don't need that. The important part about freedom is that when people are free, they become more creative and they become more energized in what they can do, and they have more opportunities. And it is in a free society that we then can strive for what I consider very important, and that is striving for excellence and striving for virtue. That should be what life is all about. But it seems that too many people have been too anxious over these last 50 or 60 years to allow the government to be involved in that. And we can't have government legislating virtue and goodness. That is only done at the expense of liberty. When the government wants to tell us what we should do to run a correct life, or what we should do to make the economy fairer to everyone, or what the foreign governments have to do to make their countries obey what we want, that has to be done at the sacrifice of liberty. And the purpose is to protect that liberty so we can have this creative energy released, which is productive and also permits us to continue to strive for excellence and virtue. I indeed believe that ideas cannot be suppressed. And as Hugo said, you know, armies can't stop an idea when the time has come. And it looks to me like the time has come. I'm a little surprised that it has, you know, arrived as it has been under these conditions, but it looks like the time has come. The time has come. We don't know exactly what is going to happen tomorrow, next month, or in 6 weeks or 6 months. But I do believe very sincerely that the ideas of liberty, which have been quiescent for so many years, and what had driven our country in the early years, and what drove our founders, is now alive and well, and will never be put to sleep again. So I close now with saying thank you very much for being here. Thank you very much for joining this peaceful, very beneficial American Revolution. And let's look forward to working hard and showing those pundits that think that we will not do well, that we do very well next month. Thank you very much.
Just wanted to let you know.